Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm going to be talking to you about my experience with Charlotte Fashion Week. I did the runway for Peace in April. So if you guys want to hear about how I got involved with that, what goes into working as an artist, and some behind the scenes photos, then keep watching. Okay, so about maybe a year ago, maybe 2 years ago, my best friend, she actually lives in Atlanta now. What up, Katie? She is a stylist, for styling clothes. And she did the Charlotte Fashion Week. And it just sounded like such a really cool opportunity. I didn't know she was doing it ahead of time, but I knew I wanted to get involved. So she came back raving about how wonderful it was. She was more so like a volunteer. Sorry guys, my boyfriend is being very loud, so I had to stop and restart. So yeah, my best friend went down to Charlotte Fashion Week, and I really wanted to be involved for the next year. I think the next year after that, I wasn't able to be involved because of some stuff I was doing with my sorority. That's another story. So this year I said that I really wanted to do it. So, in December I applied online, as an artist to help out for Charlotte Fashion Week. And then a lady by the name of Jay reached out to me, for a meet and greet, which I wasn't able to attend. But I ended up being added to a group chat type deal. And so in the group chat it was a lot of us, hair and makeup artists, and, we talked about, the looks that the designers were expecting from us and what our call times were and so on and so forth. So then, leading up to it, maybe that week, I was, super nervous / excited / I don't know, I was just, green. I was just ready for whatever was going to happen. So I ended up going up to Charlotte with my boyfriend, stayed at my sorority sister's house. And then Friday it started. Friday, we had to be there at 12, and Saturday was 12 noon until about 11 p.m. I believe we stopped working maybe 9:30, 10. But it was awesome. This was a little name badge that all the artists were wearing. But it's so cool. So we got there around 12 on Friday. We just kind of got to meet everyone and get to know who was on our team. And so then we went to set up our tables, and it just felt so real. It was amazing. And then about 2 o'clock, I would say, the models started coming in. And I believe on the first day, we had 80 models, I want to say. That was on Friday. And it was awesome. I learned so much from this experience. I did a lot of networking with models and designers, as well as getting to know how to work in the fashion show setting. It's very fast-paced. Our coordinator, Jay, she was a hairstylist. She would hand me a look and be like, get this done in 10 minutes. And so it really challenged me to learn how to move quickly without losing the beauty of the art. But I did it. So that was awesome in itself. That was a great takeaway. I will be posting the looks at the end of this video for you guys to see. I have most of the behind the scenes pictures. I'm going to be looking for the photos of the models once they were fully dressed in their outfits from the designers. But it was great. The makeup team was awesome. On Saturday, we ended up having a heart-to-heart before the show started, just about how the industry works and how to make opportunities for yourself. And honestly, you got to just, whatever you want to do, whatever you're passionate about, you just have to go out there and do it. Invest in yourself and invest and, you know, whatever supplies that you may need. But you just have to go out there and do it and believe in yourself that you're going to do a good job. Because, I mean, the worst you can do is find out that you have an opportunity for growth. Let me see. So definitely, I've always heard horror stories of, like, not really having a break to, like, eat, which we definitely did have breaks to eat. But when you're doing something that you love, it's so easy to just get wrapped up in that. And so I know on Friday, I think I went 8 hours without eating. Not because there wasn't food, because they had pizza there for us, but I was just so into what I was doing. And it wasn't until I started feeling like dizzy that I was like, hold up, I haven't eaten. So, but yeah, they were great. We were at Club 8.2.0, I think that's how you say it, or 8.2.0. And they treated us phenomenally. They had the most amazing pizza. They had like cauliflower crust as an option, as well as like regular pizza, like New York style, like the size of the slices. It was just really great. It was really great. I highly recommend it for anyone that's trying to break into the industry. A lot of times you can work as an artist. You can volunteer. So that's what we were all volunteer artists. We brought our own kits. I can show you guys what's in my kit if you want. My kit is still a mess from Fashion Week. Don't judge me. My brushes are clean, but my kit is a mess. But I can do a video if that's what you guys want to see at some point. That'll show you exactly what's in my kit and what I take with me to fashion shows. But yeah, so if you're wanting to get involved in a fashion show or something of that matter, just find the area that you want to work with. So I knew that I wanted to do Charlotte International Fashion Week. They have events like Runway for Peace. That was just the weekend. And then they had the Fashion Week in September. That's the full week. Just go to where you're trying to work with and apply. You do need a portfolio. So if you don't have a portfolio yet, I recommend getting some of your friends and doing their makeup and having them be diverse as possible. You don't want to have friends of all one nationality or race, because it's going to make your portfolio look more bland. And you want to show that you're diverse and can do different looks. So you're going to want to do maybe some special effects looks, some bridal looks, some prom looks, some super creative looks, some natural looks. Just get comfortable with the product that you're using. You also want to diversify your kit and products. You don't want to have everything Bobbi Brown. You don't want to have everything Mary Kay. You want to have a variety, because different companies work well with different skin types, or different products work well for different like types of events. So just keep that in mind. And then just practice your skill and apply. I mean, the worst they can say is we're full, try again next year. And you know what? You try again next year until you do it. So I would love to work with New York Fashion Week. That would be awesome. I'm definitely deciding to keep my feet in this pond, the pond of fashion shows. I love the high intensity and the fast-paced environment. So that's what you're interested in, then I recommend you give it a try. That's it. Stay tuned. I'll have some pictures at the end of my amazing team that I worked with. Super shout out to them, because they were so awesome. It was amazing. And then the beautiful models that I worked with. And I will provide their Instagram handles for you and their name on each photo. So you'll be able to follow them and see what they're up to. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Looking forward to seeing your comments and what you guys think. Don't forget to subscribe, share this video, tell your friends. If you know someone who's into makeup and wants to work maybe in the fashion show industry or any type of fast-paced industry, tell them to watch this video. Maybe they'll get some ideas. If you guys want to hear other things about makeup, I also do bridal makeup. I do some special effects work. So just let me know in the comments. But yeah, subscribe, tell your friends, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. All right, guys, I will see you later. Bye. To see the rest of those photos, please visit my Instagram page at @SonyaFlowers_. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. See you later. Bye.